The latest Home Assistant introduced one new food-related integration, and I'm talking about one very interesting meal planner called Mealy. Mealy is an entirely free project where you can add all of your recipes and cookbooks in one place, and you can plan when to cook them and to see how in one very easy and intuitive web interface. The Home Assistant Mealy integration is adding all of the Mealy calendars and their events inside Home Assistant, so you can make all sorts of notifications, scripts and automations. Here is what I managed to do with Mealy and Home Assistant, and afterwards I'll show you how I did it. This is my test Home Assistant, and you can see right here two cards that are closely related to Mealy Home Assistant integration. The first one is showing the Mealy today's meal, and it is some kind of a German soup or something like that. If I click on it, I'll see nothing more than the name and some kind of a history, but it is not an actionable card. Next thing is a button card that is linked to a script that I'll show you later in details. And if I click on this button, I'll receive this persistent notification, which will include my daily agenda or my daily food plan. My breakfast for today, my lunch, my dinner, and my side meal. Of course, all of this data is not real. I'm just testing the waters and I'm showing you the results. Also, this notification can be sent to my phone, or I can include that data in some other Home Assistant automations. I can do whatever I want. I also have, if all of this sounds a bit confusing to you, then please register for my upcoming Home Assistant webinar, where we'll talk about different Home Assistant installation types, their pros and cons, and one super secret and super stupid way to get started with Home Assistant on a Windows PC in under 5 seconds or 5 minutes. I'm waiting you there. The registration link is on your screen and also in the video description. If I go to the calendar section of Home Assistant, I also have 4 calendars added by Mealy integration. These are breakfast, dinner, lunch, and side calendars. I can click, of course, on the events and I can see more info about this integration. But let me quickly show you what Mealy is, because this is a very interesting project and I'm willing to dive deep in it to give it a try. Actually, I install Mealy on my local host on this laptop that I'm using right now, and I used Docker for that, but more on that later. For now, I just want to show you the interface and what Mealy can do. This is the main dashboard of Mealy. Of course, I have the days, and here I can add a lot of recipes, shopping lists, and cookbooks. And a good thing here is I can import them. You can create them manually right here and you have to type them, or you can import them from a URL. For example, you can find a great recipe for a pizza and you can type the URL here or paste the URL here, and you just have to click on create, and this thing will parse the URL and will get the recipe for you, and you add it in the Mealy. Then you can plan when you can make this meal, and you can use the recipe from here. Cookbooks are also interesting. You can add whole cookbooks or you can create them manually. And timeline. This is a timeline of recipes, shopping lists. And I also want to mention that you can import all of these from the settings. Mealy can be installed on a network attached storage or in Docker using few very short commands, as I'll show you. And after you have an instance, you have to get an API key or API token. You can get them from your user profile, manage token, and you can generate a key here. This key is needed for the Home Assistant integration. You just have to type a name and then you have to click on generate and you have to copy this key. After you got your key, you have to go to your Home Assistant integration section and you have to add a Mealy integration like that. It will ask you for a URL and for the API token. You have to paste the API token here, like that. And you have to type the URL. This is where the Mealy instance is running. Currently, Mealy is running on my laptop, which is having this IP, ending with 113. And here I have to type HTTP. And my IP, then the port on which Mealy is running. In my case, it is this one. If I click submit, Mealy will be added, but I added it already, so I'll not do that. Let me quickly show you how I install Mealy. First, I downloaded a Docker client for macOS. It is also available for Windows and Linux. After I have a Docker client, I opened my terminal and I created one docker-compose.yaml file. And this is the content of my docker-compose.yaml file. I got this information from the official Mealy documentation and I only changed the version here so that I got the latest Mealy version. And I also changed the base URL. Here. This is basically my local host. I'll link this Docker Compose YAML in the video description, so don't try to remember it, just get it from there. So after I created this Docker Compose.yaml file, I saved it and I run Docker Compose up minus D command. This one. This command will execute the instructions inside this Docker Compose YAML file. It will download the image of the Mealy and it will start it for me. It will create a container and so on and so forth. Basically everything. After all is finished, I just have to open my localhost and this port 9925. There is a simple wizard that is leading you to the configuration process where you have to configure your username and password. And basically that's it. Have in mind that Mealy is empty by default. There are no recipes inside, like you see here. I'm full of recipes. I think I have 700 and something recipes, but I didn't create them. I imported them from demomealy.io website. This is a live site where you can try Mealy from your browser, and this site is public and everyone can add recipes, cookbooks and stuff inside, and it have a lot of data inside. Some of the data is good, some of the data is bad. I mean the recipes are either good or some random characters. I created one backup. I downloaded that backup and I import this backup into my local instance, and after all these steps, which are pretty easy, I got these recipes, users, and so on and so forth. Have in mind that if you create an API key and if you import this backup, your API keys will be erased and you have to create them again and you have to add the Mealy integration once again. Next thing I did is this script. Let me show you. Mealy calendar. You have two actions. The first one will get the calendar events of these calendars, Mealy breakfast, lunch, dinner, and site for 24 hours and will store the data in the response variable called agenda. The next action is more interesting and more, how to say, technical, but don't worry, you can copy and paste this whole YAML from the video description. Unfortunately, it is not well formatted here, as I can see. Yes, now it's better. This action simply calls the persistent notification service, which is creating a notification right here, as you saw in the beginning of the video. And then it starts parsing the agenda, which is the response variable that is filled from the previous section, and everything inside will be listed and sent as a notification. You can copy and paste this without any modifications, and you can get the code from the video description. Next thing that I did is entirely optional, but I like it. I found it in the Mealy website, where it is here. I created two REST sensors as described here. Then I created one camera entity. Let me show you. Download my smart home glossary, which is full of smart home wisdom, and it is coming as one big PDF file. It is entirely free, and you can find the link on your screen and in the video description. These are the REST entities. I have to add them in my configuration.yaml file. The only thing that I changed is the IP and the port. This is the IP of my laptop, and this is the port where Mealy is listening, as defined here in this Docker Compose. And I also pasted my API token, Mealy API token, here in the headers authorization. So this is important, because otherwise this sensor will not be able to work. The first sensor is getting the today's recipe name, and the second one is getting the today's recipe ID. And I'm using this sensor in the card that you saw in the beginning of the video, right here. If I edit this card, you can see right here, this is a condition card, but this is not so important. It is optional. Basically, I'm showing this card only if this entity, Mealy today's meal, which is one of the sensors that I'm creating in the configuration.yaml. So if this entity is not having a status unknown or status unavailable, if these all conditions are true, then show this card. This is a condition card, and it is useful if something is not true of these conditions. This card will be invisible in my dashboard. But this is a picture, this is a regular picture entity, where the entity is the Mealy today's meal, this one, Mealy today's meal. This is the REST sensor that I just show you in my configuration.yaml. And the image is a camera. I forgot to show you that. I created one generic camera entity. I added one generic camera integration, and I added this as a URL. Let me show you. I'll show you here. Generic camera. This is it. I just added one generic camera. And I pasted the URL here of my Mealy. And I only changed the IP and the port, nothing else. Everything else is the same as shown here in this example. Instead of Mealy and port 900, I used my laptop IP and port 9925. Everything else stays as it is. So I created this generic camera, and I use this generic camera inside my conditional picture entity card here. This is my camera that is created by adding the generic camera integration. And this is actually showing the picture of the recipe, if there is any. Of course, all of this is just to demo the Home Assistant Mealy integration. The doors are open, everything is possible. As you know, I can add a lot of scripts and automations, and I just wanted to share with you guys what I'm currently playing with. If you like this, please share in the comments. Are you going to try this? And if you're going to try this, what automations and scripts you're planning to do? I'm Kirill, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Introduced one new Mew. The latest Home Assistant introduced one new food-related integration.